Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel, I'm Brainwa Brain. A few days ago, Blaster Master 03 was released. I picked up the digital copy for the Switch, as well as pre-ordered the physical copy. While the physical copy hasn't been shipped yet, I've been enjoying the digital copy and thought I would share my thoughts on the game. But before we begin, if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't yet, consider subscribing. That is the best way to let me know you're enjoying the content on this channel. Now let's get started. If you're not familiar with the Blaster Master Zero series, here's the official description from the first game. Blaster Master Zero is an action exploration game done in an 8-bit top-down and side-view style that harkens back to the golden age of the NES. Using the original 1988 NES title Blaster Master from Sunsoft as a base, Blaster Master Zero has many new additions, such as new areas and bosses, new gameplay elements such as extra weapons and improved gameplay, a more robust scenario, redefined and expanded exploration mechanics, and more. This description fits well with the third game and is being called the finale of the Jason saga. This game starts with a cinematic opening before any menu comes up. The opening follows the official description of the game that reads, "In the previous game, Blaster Master 02, Jason and his partner Eve finally reached their destination, the planet Sophia, after a long and arduous journey through space. However, a new threat was already lying in wait for them upon their arrival. Without warning, they were attacked, captured, and separated from each other by Sophia's military, the Sophia Force. Jason's new journey begins on Sophia after he escapes from Sophia's force base aboard his all-terrain battle tank, the G Sophia SV, and begins his search for Eve." One thing I do like in the settings on this game is it gives you a nice graphic of what the different controls are, so you get a better idea than just reading some text. You can switch your character from being in or out of the tank, and a majority of the side view areas are done in the tank, and then all the overhead areas done when you're out of the tank. And I'll show you some of that here in just a second. But this picture gives you a really good explanation of what the controls are for your different modes. So definitely take a look at this, and you can check it out again while you're playing the game in case you forget. Now if we take a look inside the options here, there's not really a whole lot to change. You can turn vibration on and off and change which button does cancel, and you can choose your language, and then you can also choose to delete your saved data. But if we go in here under controls, we'll see all the different controls and you can change what button does what. Again, I would refer back to that previous graphic to get a better understanding of what each of these do. When you select Game Start, you're given the option to choose a game save or start a new one. So in this new one I'm starting here, you'll see when I start, you get right into the action of the game. There's a little bit of a backstory here at the very beginning, kind of filling out the rest of the story, but you don't have to go back through the entire cinematic that you had when you first turned on the game. Now what is interesting here is the first enemy they throw at you, they let you know that you can't use your regular weapons on and that you'll need to use your missiles, so it kind of talks you through the gameplay elements as they're being introduced. I find it kind of interesting that they don't throw a regular enemy at you first, but throw something at you a little higher that you've got to use your special weapons for. This is kind of nice because it teaches you how to swap your weapons around and understanding the difference between them. Now, a neat gameplay mechanic in this game is that your missiles have to recharge, but the way you recharge them is simply falling from a higher height than what you normally could jump. So you just kind of get on a ledge, jump up, and then land on a lower area, and you'll see this little swooshing items around you, and your missile meter will start to charge. This is kind of cool that you can always charge it. It does kind of get tiring that if you've completely depleted it and you don't have a very high area to jump off of, that you'll just have to keep doing that over and over to get charged back up. Now you have to leave your vehicle to go into these little doors here, and this gets you into the section where you're playing the overhead view and playing as just your character. Now the game talks you through all your different weapons here and what they are, but one of the really cool elements of the game here is that it puts you at this little area where you can't progress until you learn to switch your weapons. So you see all these crystals here. When you first come through the door, you actually immediately shoot the one straight in front of you and this little gate opens. And you go through it and then you realize you can't progress past here. So when you go back and try to shoot the other crystals, they don't open. This kind of confused me for a second. I'm like, okay, what am I missing here? But then I started to notice that each gate is colored, and each gate has a picture on it. Now, if you go into your weapons, you can select the weapon that matches the gate, and then you can shoot the crystal that matches that as well. And you'll notice the base under each crystal, the color matches the weapon color. This is important because when you get later into the game, some of these crystals may not be sitting right next to the gate. So you'll need to pay attention to which weapon it needs in order to shoot it correctly. Also behind one of these gates is a conveyor belt area that you can't just walk across. You have to use a button to hit and run across it. This teaches you that element. So I can't emphasize how much I really enjoy this type of explanation of game mechanics rather than just maybe a wall of text trying to tell me everything. And at least in the previous games, there's not a whole lot of stale feeling to these mechanics. They're able to mix it up enough to where it feels fresh each time. And here I just want to show you what happens when you earn an extra weapon for your ship. So you go through this overhead perspective area and defeat this boss, and then you get the G Cruiser Shot Plus. And it tells you here that it consumes SP, so that's your little orange meter at the top. And after you come out of the level, you'll go back over here to a save point, and from here you can call your ship. Now that you're back in your ship, you can switch your weapons to this new one, and you'll notice when you use it, the orange meter depletes as you're using it. So this is just like the missile meter, where you have to recharge this by jumping from a very high area and landing. Now, if you let the weapon completely deplete, it becomes really, really weak, and your meter has to charge all the way back up before you can use it again. So if you switch to this, just be careful. You need to keep an eye on that meter. And that's definitely one of the cool things in this game, is that you'll get more upgrades to your ship. Here you'll see where you get a hover attachment for your ship, which is nice, and you continue to get new weapons as you go through the game, and the new weapons can be used in different ways to progress through the game. And you can open up new areas to progress through, and then as you get new upgrades, you'll be able to go back to previous areas and access things that you could not access before. So that's your definite Metroidvania-style gameplay. And that's it for this video. Tell me what you think. Have you played other games in this series? Are you going to pick this one up? Have you already been playing it? What are some of your favorite weapons and upgrades in this series? I'll be playing this off and on Twitch, so if you want to follow me there, the link is in the description below. I want to thank you for watching, and be good.